Hello, welcome to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, I'm making a simple holder to hold the diamond for dressing a grinding wheel. The holder consists of an aluminium bar with an adjustable handle at one end and the diamond at the other, and a rod that goes through that pushes the diamond out onto the wheel. So let's go in the workshop and see how we make it. This is the diamond grinding wheel dresser, and it's got a row of diamonds impregnated into this steel. And what I want to do today is make a holder from this piece of aluminium to hold this dresser, so when I dress the wheel, if you can imagine the wheel bouncing onto this, it will hold it firm and I'll get a good finish rather than bouncing with the wheel. To do that, I need a face that I can push up against the rest so it will be parallel with the rest of the grinding wheel, but also give me control over to stop it bouncing. So I've got this piece of aluminium.
This radius was from when I tested my ball turning attachment.
Put this in the lathe that way. And the first job is to face this off square. Drill a hole that this will fit into so that the shank of this will go right into there. And then I'll drill a hole through the side and tap that so I can hold that in position. Got some damage to the shaft here where it's been gripped, so it will go in. I'll just have to emery cloth the outside down, and then that should go off up to the face. I've thrown a burr up on here, so I'll just take the face it off again, put a chamfer on the outside. Taking the sharp edge off the corner. Match this little plastic handle I've got. That's okay. So all I need to do now is just put a flat on the back here just to take this sharp edge off. So far I've got a bore that this will fit into, and then on this end I threaded this bore so that this handle will fit in. Now I need to do two more things. Let's drill and tap a hole through the side just to give a bit of grip on that, and also find a rod that can go through the centre of this, so as I tighten this handle up it'll push this out the end to the right length. I've just found this extra long bolt which fits in the middle. I'm just going to turn the head down on this to fit this end, and then I'll chop it to length. The bolt head just fits through there. This will screw in. So the diamond fits into the holder, this little screw, and the holder runs along the edge of the work rest to keep the diamond parallel to the wheel. And then the rod goes in the back and the adjusting knob goes in the back of that. The idea is, as I dress the wheel, I can push the diamond out. So I'll start there. And once you dress the wheel, readjust the rest so it's just missing the wheel. Turn the wheel to make sure it is missing. Let me explain what we're doing when we dress a grinding wheel. If you look at a grinding wheel, the surface of the wheel, this is a side view, if you magnify the surface, you'd have lots of pieces of grit on the edge of the wheel with sharp edges, and it's the sharp edges of the grit that cuts the material. Now as you use the wheel, you're taking the sharp edges off this grit. It's a bit like emery cloth. You get a new piece of emery cloth and it cuts really fine, and the more you use it, the harder it is to get it to cut. It loses its edge off the grit, and then you're just rubbing, and that's exactly what happens on a grinding wheel. The more you use it, the little bits of grit lose their sharp edges and it becomes flat. And then what happens when you first dress the wheel, you'll find if you grind in a ladle, it'll cut the tool quite fast and it won't get the tool too hot. But as you lose the edge, it starts to rub more than cut. So by dressing the wheel, you then put the sharp bits back on the wheel. By taking a layer of grit off, you expose the next layer underneath, which the sharp edges will then start to cut better. So the first reason why you dress the grinding wheel is to expose the sharp edges of grit. And the second reason is if you've just put the wheel on, you're truing the wheel up. And by truing the wheel up, it means that if this is running out, you're making sure that all the circumference of the wheel is running true to the centre.
Oh well, that's it for today. I hope that information was useful, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.